Black Americans have made up an important part of American culture and demography for hundreds of years now, and even before emancipation in the modern era, Black Americans have had their own identity and culture form that's a unique fusion of many different civilizations and has led to the position of most Black people in the United States having ancestry and roots from many different countries and ethnic groups. The 13 colonies, which would later become the United States of America, were founded by Britain in 1607 with the establishment of Jamestown in modern Virginia, and it was around a decade later in 1619 that the first Africans were brought to the United States as slaves to aid in the production of crops such as tobacco. One thing that seems to confuse people is the terminology and vernacular surrounding the terms African American and Black American, and as I'm 1/4 Black American and the majority of my extended family here in Texas are Black, here's how I've always seen it. The terms are more often than not used interchangeably, with many people of African descent from around the world identifying as Black, but generally the term Black American refers exclusively to the ethnic group that formed from Americans of African descent that are descended from slaves in the United States, while the term African American can be used to describe more recent sub-Saharan African immigrants to the U.S., although it can also be used more loosely to encompass all people of African descent in the United States. I do, however, have family members that are adamantly opposed to describing themselves as African American, seeing it as more of an artificial label, seeing how their identity lies within the common development and struggles of the Black American community that had led to the formation of the group across the entirety of the country over a span of hundreds of years. It's similar to how many white Americans have had their ancestors established in the country for so long that they no longer identify themselves with any foreign nation, but rather the shared experiences of their American communities that just so happen to be of European descent and would never describe themselves as European American. At the end of the day, labels are subjective, and anyone can identify however they want, of course, but it's important to recognize that Black people in America do have their own ethnic identity separate from other people of African descent from places like Latin America, the Caribbean, and Africa, and that not all people that have African ancestry are a cultural and ethnic monolith. Ever since American independence in 1776, around 90% of people of African descent in the United States were enslaved, while around 10% were known as free people of color, of whom the majority were mixed race, either being the result of a white woman having a child with a slave, or a slave master deciding to free the children he had sired with a slave woman, most of the time on his deathbed. However, there were cases of entire slave families being freed or having their freedom bought for them during this time period as well. These free people of color were some of the building blocks for post-emancipation Black culture, with there being many Black poets, writers, and preachers as early as the late 1700s. Because Black Americans are such a diverse plethora of African ethnic groups, as we'll discuss later, their cultural background has inspiration from many different sources influencing their language and genetics, as well as taking occasional innovation from non-African groups as well. Slaves in the United States, although often prohibited from learning how to read, had borrowed many aspects of Southern American culture, which stems from the Georgian era in British history and the British Isles, including not only England, but Ireland, Scotland, and Wales, as the vast majority of non-English slave owners in the southern United States were of Celtic origin, especially Irish and Welsh, which is why Jones, a traditionally Welsh surname, is predominant among Black Americans today, which we'll expound upon later. As most people already know, Black slaves were congregated around the southern United States, having both the highest proportion and numbers of anywhere in the country, with slave owners stopping slaves from teaching their children the native languages of their people or practicing their original religions, which were mostly animistic, although around 20% of Africans taken to the United States were originally Muslim. Because the Africans were not allowed to spread their religion or language onto their offspring, the various tribes that would have otherwise never mingled within the continent of Africa found themselves in a common situation and struggle, and ethnic differences between slaves soon became irrelevant, which led to the rise of modern Black America through the fusion of genetics and culture, which primarily stem from West and Central Africa, along with the British Isles. Although the South had been the homeland of Black Americans, a few decades after the end of the Civil War and emancipation, a mass migration of blacks from southern states began heading towards the northern United States, and a movement known as the Great Migration appeared that lasted up until the 1970s. Starting almost immediately after the end of the American Civil War in 1865, black Americans began to impact the larger American culture as a whole, with the first black politician, Hiram Rhodes Revels, being elected in 1870 as a congressman from Mississippi, first black governor being P.B.S. Pinchback, who served as governor of Louisiana in 1872, along with many black entrepreneurs such as Robert Reed Church, a businessman and landowner from Memphis in the 1870s, who was worth around $700,000 in 1880, which would be nearly $18 million adjusted for inflation in 2017. Other prominent figures in black American philosophy and politics would include Frederick Douglass, Booker T. Washington, and W.E.B. Du Bois, who all held opinions and beliefs that spanned across the entirety of the political and social spectrum. The percentage of African Americans in the United States peaked around 1770, when they were 21.4% of the population, however it began to decline after this period, reaching a low of 9.7% in 1930, and since then the percentage has stabilized and has been steadily growing, with there being around 40 million African Americans in the U.S. today, although around 4 million of those are of Caribbean descent, and 4 million are recent African immigrants or their descendants. By taking DNA and genetic estimates from a variety of sources, the average black American, not taking recent African or Caribbean immigrants into account, is 76% sub-Saharan African, 21.4% European, 1.3% Native American, 1.1% Middle Eastern or North African, and 0.2% Asian. Now, obviously, this is not standard for all black people, and most people will be around this average, although there are extreme outliers. In many southern states, like Louisiana and South Carolina, at least 10% of white Americans have at least 1% African DNA, and 1% of white Americans have around 10% African ancestry and probably don't even know. The gene pool of Hispanic and Latino Americans is also around 3 to 5% African. African slaves were taken from certain slave regions here in Africa, with around 26% being from the Bight of Biafra in modern Southeast Nigeria, 24% from West Central Africa in modern Angola and Congo, 15% from the Gold Coast or modern Ghana, 14% from Senegambia or modern Senegal and Gambia, 8% from the Windward Coast or modern Ivory Coast, 8% from Sierra Leone and Guinea, 4% from Benin, and around 2% from Southeast Africa or Mozambique. Judging by these numbers, most likely around 18% of modern black American DNA of African origin is of Yoruba extraction, who are the largest ethnic group in southern Nigeria and also stretch into neighboring Benin. 14% is Igbo, who are another Nigerian group. 12% is believed to be of Fulani origin, who are a nomadic people group scattered throughout West Africa, while the other half of the African gene pool is spread across many other ethnic groups from many nations in Africa. A small handful of these slaves were also brought from more exotic locations like Ethiopia and Madagascar, including Robert Reed Church, who is of partial Malagasy descent. Although the black American gene pool has become extremely diverse throughout its evolution, the ethnic group that has the highest degree of genetic similarity with American blacks in Africa today, other than the Americo-Liberians who are descended from black Americans that migrated to Liberia in the 1800s, are definitely the ethnic groups of southern Nigeria, especially the Igbo and Yoruba, while the majority of the European DNA for black Americans originates in the English, Irish, Scottish, and Welsh. Many traditionally black-sounding names that are seen in many black Americans, such as the name Tyrone, is actually of Irish extraction, originating in the Ulster area of Ireland, something I found out from reading my friend Bobby Sonora's The Book of Black Names, where he highlights many of the etymological origins behind famous black-sounding names in the United States. There are also subsets within the black American population, such as the Gullah or Geechee people of the Gullah Coast in South Carolina, Georgia, and Florida, who are of Afro-Bahamian extraction, and as such, many in the community speak a Creole language very similar to Bahamian Creole, while the Gullah, on average, are far more African than other black Americans, being only 5% European and 95% African, mostly from Central Africa rather than West Africa. The Louisiana Creoles of Louisiana are one of the more interesting subgroups of Americans of African descent, as their culture has been heavily Europeanized, and they are surrounded by other Franco-descended groups, like the Cajuns and French Canadians, and have a bit higher European and Native American admixture, which we've discussed in a video over the differences between Louisiana Creoles and Cajuns. The Black American community has a very unique origin among the major ethnic groups of America. Although originally downtrodden, suffering from some of the worst human rights abuses of any group in history, the group was able to rise from the ashes of the Civil War and had an economic recovery the likes of which historians would have never thought possible. As Larry Elder has pointed out, with the total GDP of Black America being $1.3 trillion, making it larger than even the country of Nigeria or any other African nation by far, being larger than even Australia or the Netherlands. They're a very interesting group to learn about, and it's important to remember, just like any other group, no two people share the exact same beliefs or characteristics, so it's better to treat others as individuals rather than a collective. Be sure to let me know your thoughts on Black and African American history and genealogy, and I'll probably do a video on the Gullah and Caribbean Americans in a video soon. As always, thanks for watching, everyone. This has been Mason, and I'll see you next time.